Are you ready to experience the heart-pounding account of an intense close-range intercept with a violent EF4 tornado? Imagine being in the midst of Iowa's high-risk tornado outbreak, where the risks are high and the stakes are even higher. As the storm approached, a team of scientists and researchers set out on a mission to intercept the tornado and gather critical data to improve our understanding of these extreme weather events. How close did they get? Let's talk about it all. On March 31, 2023, eastern Iowa was hit with many strong to violent tornadoes as a result of the first high-risk warning issued by the SPC in more than 2 years. To our great relief, the tornadoes that ripped through Iowa did not claim anyone's life. Sadly, many other regions did not share the same good fortune. The close-range wedge tornado that can be seen in this video has been provisionally given an EF4 rating, meaning it is violent, and has maximum winds of 170 miles per hour. A probable tornado was detected by storm chaser Brett Adair as it passed past Little Rock in the state of Arkansas. On Friday, a severe weather outbreak shook the middle of the U.S., unleashing supercells that produced strong, long-track tornadoes. The threat is anticipated to persist overnight. At least 4 people have been killed, and at least dozens more people have been injured as a result of tornadoes that have roared through half a dozen states. Search and rescue operations are currently ongoing in an effort to locate additional casualties. The entire severe weather warning zone that spanned 87 million people across 23 states on Friday has shrunk in size as the atmosphere continues to become more stable over the midnight hours. The Storm Prediction Center issued a warning about a very rare high-risk zone, classifying it as a level 5 out of 5 danger for severe storms during the afternoon and evening. The likelihood of catastrophic storms occurring in major cities such as Chicago, Nashville, and St. Louis was significantly increased. During the peak of the activity, tornado watches were issued for an area that stretched from near the Gulf Coast to the Great Lakes. As severe thunderstorms packing catastrophic gusts of up to 90 miles per hour approached the Chicago area, a severe thunderstorm warning has been issued for the entire Chicago metropolitan area. Monitoring storms as they move eastward into Saturday, active severe weather watches are displayed below. These watches will either appear in red to indicate a tornado watch or in yellow to indicate a severe thunderstorm watch. Storms that may be capable of delivering severe weather in and close to the warned area are indicated by the use of the word watch. The Storm Prediction Center has identified 2 regions of concern along the East Coast that might be affected by severe storms on Saturday. These locations have the potential to produce huge hail, damaging winds, and potentially an isolated tornado. The northern region of concern extends from Ohio eastward to the I-95 corridor and incorporates significant urban areas such as New York City and Philadelphia. There have been multiple reports of damage as a result of a line of severe weather that moved through Ohio into the afternoon on Saturday. It was claimed that trees and electricity lines had fallen in the area of Coshocton, Ohio, which is situated around 60 miles northeast of Columbus. A report from a 911 call center said that residents in the northeastern part of Ohio, including in the cities of Dover, Mineral City, and Sharonsville, had reported widespread downed power lines as well as trees that had fallen on houses. There were no reports of injuries coming from those areas. As a result of the extreme weather, fiber optic cables were brought down in Belmont, Ohio, which is located just west of Wheeling in the state of West Virginia. In some spots, including Cleveland and Middlefield, Ohio, the maximum sustained wind speed was over 50 miles per hour. The southern region encompasses both the Carolinas and Georgia, both of which have the potential to see severe storms if the atmosphere is sufficiently destabilized by the day's heating. Warnings have been issued for tornadoes in Little Rock, Arkansas. A tornado warning was issued for the communities surrounding Little Rock just before 2:30 local time, and damage was reported west of the city. The tornado was the first one to be detected on Friday amid what would turn out to be a significant springtime outbreak in the middle of the country. The footage captured by a drone gives us our first glimpse at the tremendous damage caused by what appears to be a tornado in Little Rock, Arkansas. As a result of the dangerous storm, the National Weather Service office in Little Rock temporarily moved its responsibilities to the office in Memphis, and the meteorologists took refuge. This footage captured by storm chasers shows a number of damaged residences as well as streets that were obstructed by debris. Even an Amazon delivery car gave the appearance of being overturned by the storm, and storm chasers reported spotting injured victims as they pursued the storm. After the storm, emergency services were in the process of searching for and rescuing people, and they reported that at least 20 people had been treated at local medical centers. According to Brian Emfinger, a storm chaser working for Live Storms Media, there are well-built homes that are damaged. There are also a number of shopping centers that have been damaged, including damage to their roofs. Officials in Pulaski County reported a number of injuries, but there were not sufficient ambulances available to transport those who were hurt to the hospital. Governor Sarah Huckabee Sanders of Arkansas stated that a considerable amount of damage was sustained in the middle region of the state, and that she is in communication with those who are providing emergency assistance. According to a tweet sent out by Governor Sanders, he is praying for all those who were and remain in the path of this storm. The assistance of the National Guard has been sought by the mayor of Little Rock to assist with relief efforts in the areas of the city that were severely damaged. After the declaration of a state of emergency, locals were strongly advised to remain inside their homes and avoid using the roads. According to the National Guard, 100 men of the organization were sent out to assist with various chores and traffic details. A nearby high school served as a temporary shelter for people who were displaced because of the storm. At least one fire station was damaged by the storm, according to the officials, which made it more difficult to provide prompt assistance. Reports of a powerful tornado in the northeastern part of Arkansas. Communities in and around Terrell, which are located to the north of Memphis, Tennessee, have also been declared to be under a state of tornado emergency. The area that was hardest damaged in Arkansas was the middle section of the state. At least two people have been reported dead in the town of Wynn, according to the governor, who stated that she was aware of this. Significant power outages were recorded in Cross County, Arkansas, with more than 50% of consumers unable to obtain electricity as a result. Photos taken in Wynn, Arkansas, revealed trees that had fallen and damaged homes, as well as the high school that served the neighborhood. Will Nunley with Fox Weather is currently in the devastated town of Wynn, Arkansas, where he reports that the locals are in a state of disbelief. Over in this area, we have a number of residences that have sustained considerable structural damage. There are enormous trees that have fallen on residences. According to Nunley, this is the very early moments right now of search and rescue operations. Will Nunley, a multimedia journalist with Fox Weather, shows the considerable structural damage that is caused in Wynn, Arkansas, as a result of a huge tornado that passed through the area. A woman who lived in Wynn was at work when the tornado hit, and when she got home, she discovered that her house had been completely leveled. She uttered the following words, "I'm in shock right now, but I'm praying that everybody is okay." The sound of the tornado, which only lasted for a short while, was likened by many who experienced it to that of a washing machine, and it was rather intense. Nunley was informed by locals that they had received adequate warning as the tornado sirens began ringing more than half an hour before the storm actually arrived. There have been reports of tornadoes in Illinois. Storm chasers in the area of Eureka, Illinois, reported seeing a tornado, prompting the National Weather Service to issue multiple tornado warnings for the cell. The hamlet can be reached by car in roughly 2 hours from the city of Chicago. Even though there were no initial reports of damage, meteorologists warned that flying debris might be harmful. A tornado was spotted by storm chasers in the central Illinois near Morton, according to their reports. It was stated that the roof of a theater that was located closer to Chicago had collapsed as a result of the storms. According to Fox 32 Chicago, the authorities were treating the occurrence as a mass casualty event, and at least one person had passed away as a result of the incident. Following the passage of severe weather across the region, the band known as the Morbid Angel announced that their scheduled performance at the Apollo Theater in Belvedere, Illinois, would not take place. The officer of the governor has been made aware of the situation, and they have offered their complete support to those who have been hurt. During the strong storms, a witness stated that there were hundreds of people inside the venue when the roof suddenly caved in. At the time of the building's collapse, the local area was under a tornado warning. However, it is currently unknown if a tornado, destructive winds, or heavy rain were the cause of the building's fall. Outside of the arena, there were seen to be more than a dozen ambulances bringing injured people to the nearby medical facilities. Tornadoes are being tracked by Fox Weather in eastern Iowa. On Friday afternoon, the tornado made its way into Iowa, which was the third state to witness its formation. A very unusual PDS tornado watch was issued for the region since the southeastern section of the state was predicted to be in the path of potentially damaging storms. Although a tornado warning was issued for several counties, the majority of the communities in those counties are rural, so the number of people who lost power was very low. Students at the University of Iowa, which is located in Johnson County, were advised to seek cover when the county was added to the list of areas under a tornado warning. Doppler radar at the Fox Forecast Center recorded debris that was lofted high up into the sky, which is typically an indicator that there is a violent tornado on the ground. On the basis of radar characteristics, the meteorologists at the NWS believe that the tornado that struck the areas around Ottumwa was an EF2 or an EF3. A storm chaser near Martinsburg, Iowa, took a photo of a tornado as it moved through a rural neighborhood. It is possible that the same cell was responsible for producing the big tornado that was photographed. The extreme weather in the state of Iowa resulted in the destruction of several barns in the state's eastern region, although there were no reports of any injuries as a direct consequence of the storm. It was stated that there was significant damage further north and east, outside of Iowa City. Photos taken in the neighborhood of Coralville revealed scattered debris and automobiles that had sustained damage. It appeared as though the storm made direct contact with an apartment building, as there was significant damage to the structure's roof as well as the third story. After sunset, a supercell passes through the northern part of Mississippi. After the sun went down, storm chasers followed a supercell that was proven to include a tornado into the northern portion of the state. The governor of Mississippi, Tate Reeves, warned residents of Tunica and DeSoto counties to take precautions as a tornado was moving in their direction. Photos taken in Tunica County, Mississippi, showed significant damage sustained by mobile homes, although a storm chaser said that they were unaware of any injuries. The location that was affected was located more than 100 miles to the north and west of where storms had left a path of destruction just 1 week before. As the storm pushed towards southern areas of the Volunteer State, there were reports of hundreds of power outages along the line that divides Mississippi and Tennessee. After sundown on Friday, there was a tornado that went through the northern part of Mississippi. Observations made by storm chaser Brett Adair reveal the presence of a menacing wall cloud over Tunica. That's all for the video today. We will be right back with more such videos. Don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to our channel.